through our breaks, I'm happy to answer further questions. As you can imagine, my friend here can't stay out in this temperature very long. Are there any quick questions before we end?
Yes.
Yeah.
Show me where that tri-tip would be.
So the tri-tip.
That's very popular.
And actually, it's easier for you to see it here. A little more confusing when we get the pieces. So if you can imagine, here's your sirloin, okay? Where it's, when you see it starting to jump up, pump up, that's the sirloin section, okay? And basically right here is where we would cut the round, okay? So this section here is the sirloin. So this is all top sirloin here, okay? We make a cut, basically a seam between two muscles, and this is your bottom sirloin. And the reason that we call it the tri-tip is because it's three muscles. Three of those four muscles that came from the water stuff. Because remember, your ball tip is right there. Make a cut here. This is your tire tip on the bottom sirloin. Okay. And then on into the flat, and we're starting to make the flat a cut as well. Some chefs are utilizing the flat. There's a lot of value-added products that use the flat as well. Yes.
Just had a question, quick. As long as you have it out there, I think you touched on it earlier with the chuck, the teres major or the petite tender.
Yes.
Is that under up underneath?
Yes, it's under the blade. Teres means three-headed, so it's running towards the arm. Absolutely. Teres is getting a lot more popular in food service. It's starting to chase the flat iron. I don't particularly care for the name, because that's its actual muscle name, whereas we get flat iron a different name.
Where's the knuckle in all that?
The knuckle?
Yeah.
So again, the knuckle is that ball tip, so if you remember your quadriceps muscle, okay, so it's coming off here. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4 quadriceps. Okay, ball tip, knuckle, all pretty much the same interchangeable phrase is right here in the front of the leg, right above the knee, basically. Yes.
You said this is a heifer. How much beef is heifer versus steer?
They're very comparable. But commonly, there will be a slightly favor the steer. We're talking maybe 1%. So it's not very different as far as weights are concerned.
Okay. Well, I was just wondering, as far as market goes, I always thought when I think beef, I think steer.
They're pretty much the same marketability.
Okay.
Kind of an interesting fact. You can tell the sex of, tell the sex of a carcass when it's tame like this. Because heifers or cows will have a smoother fat in the area where the udder would have been. So that's a smoother fat, so you can tell that that's a heifer, whereas a steer would have bubbly fat, we like to call it. I mean, it'd be more like the fat that you see around the kidneys would be that bubblier fat. So that's how you can tell the difference between.
It basically fills the void in the scrotum where the testicles were. It makes it that bubbly.
What's a heiferette then?
Heiferette?
those are the ones that are of age, right? Have been bred, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so they can, but they haven't had their first calf.
One real quick note, and they bisected the kidney here for me just to market it. If there's somebody wants to run right quick before the break and see. We do bisect these a lot of the time for inspection. This would not pass inspection for its kidney because of the discoloration and the scarring. Okay, some of these are not markable, others are. That's a big part of inspection as well.
Okay.